Welcome to Life in the Middle. This is a show where I talk about my life in middle age, and Elena talks about her life
in middle school.
And you might have noticed that we're not in our minivan today, and that's because this is a super special episode of Life in the Middle.
Speaking of special, we have our number one fan,
Calla! Hello! We have a special guest today. Calla's here.
She's casually just falling.
And so before, we also are going to be introducing our pet, Scoby, today. But before we get to that, we're going to talk about life in middle school because school's out for
summer!
Summer.
You love us.
So how did things wrap up, girls, in middle school? You just finished 7th grade. You're getting ready to go into 8th grade. Tell us about middle school. If you had to sum up the ending of middle school in one word, what would it be?
Lit.
Dramatic.
Dramatic. There was a lot of drama happening that last week of 7th grade.
Sad.
Sad.
My best friend's moving.
Not this one. Other one.
Not you. Right.
Bailey.
That's right. Do you hear that, people? Life in middle school isn't easy.
Thank goodness you only have to go through it once.
Still, well, 3 years, technically. But once.
So, Calla, yes. Tell us about how you became our biggest fan.
I'm best friends with her. I live over there. Yes. She's my adoptive mother. Yay! I watch Andrew's stuff, her stuff. I'm here.
It's a lot to keep up with, the nails.
But she keeps up so well.
I know. She's the only person who actually keeps up with
the
blog, the social media, the Andrew's YouTube, our Life in the Middle show.
Our Scoby,
our craft projects. Oh, yeah.
That was great.
No, I love that. We looked at his little person photos.
The glow up is glorious.
Okay. And how, if you had to describe the Neal family to someone, what would you say, Calla?
In one word or in a couple of words?
However many words you need.
Okay. They're funny, crazy, interesting, one of a kind. Awesome. My second family.
Pretty much. We love Calla too.
Yay!
She's one of several people.
Cameraman down. RIP our cameraman.
Rest in peace.
Show our cameraman that's having a coughing fit.
It's okay.
Okay.
No, I'm fine. Right.
No, I'm fine.
We have a professional cameraman today, Andrew Neal of Andrew Neal Films.
Follow him.
All right, go watch them. They're really
so
funny.
Today's topic is very special. The middle age topic. We're going to be showing you our Scoby, because I have been brewing kombucha, and the reason for this here we'll show you the word kombucha is because this is a fermented tea. It's very good for you. It's high in probiotics, so it helps heal your gut. That sounds really gross, and middle schoolers don't like to think about that.
No.
But in order to make it, you have this thing. It's called a SCOBY, which stands for Symbiotic Culture of Bacteria and Yeast.
I call him Kobe.
You call him Kobe.
It literally grows on the top.
It's nasty.
Have tried to convince Elena that because it's a living organism, it's actually our pet.
No, I'm going to convince you. I named him. I forgot his name. I was going to print out a label and put it on there.
Not Kobe.
But I named him.
I know, but because of your deep desire to have a pet.
Yeah, we can't have a dog, so we have a living bacteria in
a
jar.
So we have a bacteria.
Of tea.
See, the family's weird. See, my one word already brought up. Weird.
And so today, our Scoby has now doubled in size, and we have to reach in there.
And rip him apart.
And pull it apart.
So we can make another Kobe Jr. Kobe Jr.
And we have never done this before, so we are doing this for you live, our very first time. We've all washed our hands.
With vinegar.
You don't want to use antibacterial soap. And I'm going to reach in there. It's a little bit like a jellyfish. I'm going to reach in there and grab it. Mm. I'm going to throw it in here. Mm. And
are your hands going to fit in
there? I don't know.
Just
but
do
I,
one hand. I do you need it. To do Elena's hands? Hers
oh,
is
gosh. Mm. I got to get it. I
don't want to touch it. You're like an inch away and you're like, no.
Oh, gosh. See all the gross stuff. See all the gross stuff growing on the bottom.
Oh, ew!
Now we have to pull it apart. Okay, so before we do you guys want to touch it and see what it?
It's hard.
It's like a jellyfish.
It's like a overcooked noodle. No, it's an undercooked noodle. Sorry.
I don't like it.
So. So this was the original SCOBY.
Ew.
That's how big it was.
Oh,
and this is all the SCOBYs that have grown. Oh my gosh, this is so gross.
Oh, it made a sound.
And
oh no.
So we're just gonna pull that. Oh, this is easier than I thought.
That's
all we have to do is pull that off.
Is that its own SCOBY or is that the SCOBY and that's just what it made?
This is what it gave birth to.
Oh my gosh.
It's bigger than itself.
Look at that. It like quadrupled in size.
I want to squish it, but I don't want to squish it.
You want to touch it?
No, I want
to touch it. Squish.
Oh, he feels funny.
So ew! He's sweating.
It's very healthy. We're gonna take the new SCOBY.
No, I want to hold the SCOBY. Okay. I mean, wait, which one am I gonna put in there?
We're gonna put it in here. Do you want to put it in?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, gross. Mm-hmm. Put the new one in there.
The big one or the small one?
The gigantic one.
Mm-hmm. Callie, you get that side. I get this side. Oh my goodness gracious! Ah, ew, it's slimy.
And then we have to put a cup of the
strawberry. Drop it, Elena.
It made a sound.
We have to put this in there to keep it alive. It can only be in glass, just so you guys know. So we're gonna put some starter tea in there, and then we're gonna put some starter tea in this one to keep it alive, and then we're gonna start bottling our kombucha.
It was squishy.
Wait, so it was squishy, but not squishy.
It also,
it's tea, because Elena was telling me it's soda.
It's like soda.
And I'm like, it doesn't look like
carbonated. We're going to put some juice in here, in these, and we're going to let it ferment for 3 to 7 more days with the juice, and it will actually get fizzy and carbonated.
Oh, he's so cute.
Oh, look, you know what we could do?
He has a little tail.
Okay.
This one.
You go.
Okay, so to wrap up our show, we're going to taste some kombucha that I made. Elena has really strong hands with the last brew. And this has...
Oh,
that's the carbonation! And we like to strain it with a little spoon because it does have like a baby SCOBY in the bottom.
But Mom, you need to pour it slowly because...
I know. So,
look, it's
stuck to the spoon.
No.
I'm going to let Calla and Elena taste the kombucha. Try not to get any SCOBY in your mouth. It won't hurt you. You can eat it.
It's just not very nice. It's just...
Tell us what you think about it.
It's lumpy.
Rate and review.
It looks like apple juice. Like,
I'm going to get a fork and get my SCOBY out.
No, just go ahead and taste it. We don't have much camera space.
Use your mouth as a filter.
The camera's going to run out.
Okay.
It's okay.
Here, put it in here. Okay. Give it a taste, girls.
Oh, while I'm doing this.
It smells like apple juice.
Our question for you guys today
is... We're wrapping up with a question.
Should middle schoolers in the summer have a time they need to wake up, or should they just sleep as long as they want, at random?
And Calla says...
Yes.
I say no.
We should be able to sleep as late as we want.
Should be allowed to sleep as late as you want.
I don't think we should, because some people have, like, if you have a schedule going on...
Yeah, it depends on, like, your schedule.
It's not healthy to just sleep and then all of a sudden have to wake up at 6:30 and then go to bed at, like, 2 in the morning, because that's part of your old schedule. So I think you should have, like... He's stepping closer. You should, like, wake up at maybe, like, 7:30 and then go to bed at, like... Whatever time. But
well,
we're talking about
waking up, not going to sleep. Like, no, as long as you go to sleep at a decent time.
You shouldn't have to wake up at 2 in the afternoon. It's like...
So you should keep a regular schedule.
You should keep a regular schedule. You shouldn't just be sleeping and waking up.
Okay. It's really good. It tastes like fizzy apple juice. Like, the smell is off-putting at first.
Because it's a little bit vinegarish.
Yeah, it's like... And
the
then,
first
like,
drink is really a doozy.
Yep.
Okay, so viewers... We'd like to hear your opinion. Should middle schoolers be allowed to sleep as late as they want in the summer? And what about middle-aged people? Should they ever be allowed to sleep?
No. They need to wake up and serve us middle school children.
All right. Thanks for watching. Bye. Oh, wait. Tune in next week because we're going to post our special fashion edition where we're going to talk about Elena, how she got this cute new shirt.
Oh, I'm going to be watching this one first.
Bye.
Yes.
Are you gonna end it?